are you all? I know you are fine at home as you are taking care of your health, right? Daily we have to wash our hands, we have to drink warm water, we have to keep cleanliness in our surrounding, and always we have to use the mask whenever we are going to outside. But you have to stay home and stay here. Without reason, don't go outside. Students, today we are going to start our third lesson, Mathematics, SCF and LCM. In that, see the page number 15, factorizing a number into its prime factor. Today what we have to do? We have to factorize the number, okay, to its a prime number. So, a simple but important rule given by Euclid is often used to find the GCD or SCF and LCM of numbers. The rule says that any composite number can be written as the product of prime number. What that rule says? The composite number, it is the product of prime number. Okay, when the prime numbers are multiplied and then you got the composite number. See the prime number 16. Remember, to write a given number as a product of its a prime factor is to be factorized into primes. See, whenever you want the product, when you want the prime number, then you have to factorize this number into its the prime number. Okay. For example, we are seeing here the example of the 63. See, what is the factor of the 63? Which are the prime number? Then you have to find out. Okay. Then, what is the 63 is? We have to find out the factor of the 63. Then, say any two numbers, which is the product of 63? Or whose number, whose multiplication is the product 63? That we can give the 7 and 9. Right? Now, can you give the factors of this 7? No, there is no factor of 7. So, we have to write this 7 as it is. Okay? But we can factor this 9. Then, what is the factor of the 9? Which are the prime number of the 9? That is 3 into 3. 3 is a 9. Right? As we can factorize this number. See, what is the factor of 63? That is the 7 and 9. But what is the factor of 7? No. It is only 7, so we have to write. What is the factor of 9? That is 3 and 3. 3 is a 9. So, what is the factorize of this 63? Is 6. Factor of this 63 is 7 into 3 into 3. When we multiply this number, then what you got the answer? 63. Like that also you can check your answer is correct or wrong. See, there is an example. Two methods are given. As how we can find out our factorize by the two methods. That is by the vertical method and horizontal method. So, in our practice set, we are going to learn about the two methods of factorize. Okay, that is the vertical method and horizontal method. Let us think. Start with our practice set 11. Page number 17. Practice set. See, in that first example, what you want to factorize the following number into prime. What we have to do? We have to factorize that number. Whatever the question is given, we have to factorize into its a prime number. So, what is the first question there? 32. See, we have today in this practice set, we have solved this factorized by the two methods. First one is vertical method and horizontal method. Okay. Then, first by the vertical method, how we can solve, how we can factorize, we have to write like this. In the vertical method, we are going to solve. See, what is the factor of this 32? We have to divide this number. If there is a unit less, there is an even number, so we have to divide this number by the even number. Okay. And if the unit less, there is an odd number like the 3, 5, 7, 9. So, that number we have to divide by the odd number. That you have to remind. So, it is easy to understand which number you have to take. See, here is a 2. That is an even number. So, we have to divide this number by the 2. That is 2. 2 1 is 2. What is remaining here? 3 minus 2, 1. And the next number is 2. That is a 12. 2 6 is 12. Now, what is here? 16. Again, even number, so we can divide by this 2. 2 8 is 16. Then next, 2 4 is 8. 2 2 is 4. 2 1 is 1. When there is a 1 answer, we have to stop. As our answer is finished. So what factor we got? 2 2 2 2 and 2. When we do this multiplication of these two numbers, we got the answer 32. Let's see in the horizontal manner also. In horizontal method, how we can write? See, we can write the 2 16 la, or sorry, or 16 to the. This is factor, right? 16 to the 32. So, divide this again. 2 8 the 16. Then again, we have to write this number as it is. And which number have we have to factorize? That number we have to factor. Then 2 4 is the 8. Then next, when we divide this 2, see how many times we have 3? That times we have to, 3 times, right? That then 3 times we have to write 2 as it is and again factorize this number, that is 2 to the 4. See how many times now 2 is there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And in horizontal method, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is, in both the methods we got the same answer. But there is a different way to solve your answer. This is of the factorized method of the vertical and this is of horizontal. Got it? See, in a horizontal method, other way also you can use. That is, if there is a number in C1, 32. In which other table we can or factorize it? Like I know, 4 and 8. You can write add 4, 8 the 32, 8, 4 the 32. Right? Then factorize this 2. 2 to this 4. How? 2 to the 4. And this 8, 2 4 the 8. Then again write this 2 number as it is. Because now it is the, there is no factor of 2. Right? 2 to the 4. See, again we got the same number, that is 5 times 2. When we do the multiplication of 5 times 2, we got the 32. So, in the horizontal method, you can write in any way. As we can take one number and factorize it, you can do like this also. Depend on you, how you have to solve. But answer should be correct and same. Then, see the next example. What is the next number? 57. Now what we have to take? 57. First we are going to solve in the factorized method. Sorry, vertically method. That is 57 we have to write here. Now here is the odd number. So we cannot start with our even number. Okay. Let us start with the 3. See, now we have to divide this number by the 3, that is the odd number. You have to check first. It will be divided by the 3 or not, it will be divided by 5, like that. Okay. Now first we are going to divide by 3. What we answer what now? 3 1 is 3. Then 5 minus 3, that is what remaining here? 2. And this 7, that is 27. Then 3 9 is 27. Right? in your answer we got 19. Now you know in which 19 rules of which product, which prime numbers product? No, 19 is not in any number in multiplication, right? So we have to write 19 as it is. Okay, 19 was the 19. Like that we can do. Next in horizontal method, what is the our question? Is 57 then 3 times that. As it is, we can write. See, now there is no factor of 19. So, this is your final answer. What is our final answer? 57 is equal to 3 into 19. This is your final answer. I make the box to your final answer. I hope you understood what we have to do. We have to divide this number by the depend on it is even number or odd number. Okay. And in horizontal method in any way you can write, but the answer is proper one. Okay. Now let us start with the third example. Let's see the fourth example. Okay, see the fourth example. That is 150. Okay, again you have to draw. Now here, even number. By which number we can divide? 2. 2 7 is 14. 15 minus 14 is 1. And this 0. That is 10. Then 2 5 is 10. Then see your odd number. We cannot divide this number by this 3 also. Because in the table of 3, there is no unit plus 5 number. So we have to divide this number by the 5. Otherwise you know that rule also, as if there is a in unit place there is a 5, then you can divide this number by the 5 or 10, right? You can divide this number by 5. Then next, 5 is the 5. What is your remaining? 7 minus 5, that is 2. Then 2 and your 5, 25. Then 5, 5 is the 25. Then 5, 3 is the 15. And 3, 1 is the 3. Okay, like that you can do. Then next, in a horizontal method, 150 is equal to, we can take 60, we have to divide this number, you can factor it, or otherwise you can write this same number also or in different method also. Okay, then 275, 2 into, what is the your answer? 6, same we can write as it is. It is depend on you, otherwise I can show you other method how you can write. Now 2 as it is, 5 as it is, we can write 3 5 is the 15 or 5 3 is the 15. This is our number, this is our answer. Okay, then what is the product or prime numbers of the 150? That is 2, 5, 3, 5. Or you can write 2, 5, 5, 3. Okay, in other also how we can write? Okay, if we start with other number, that is the 15 into 10, then 3 5 is 15, 5 2 is 10. See, again same number you got 3 5 5 2. 3 5 5 2. Answer will be same. But in any way you can solve this example. Let us start with the our 6th number 208. Question number 6, 208. Do again, draw it. 208 even number, so we can divide by the 2. 2 1 is 2, 2 0 is 0, 2 4 is 8. Then again by the 2. 2 5 is 10, 2 2 is 4. Then 26. Okay, then divide this number, that is 13. Now can you give me answer what is the factor of the 13? No, that is then we have to write 13 as it is 13 was the third thing. So what is our answer? 208 is equal to, you can write 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. How many times 2? 1, 2, 3, 4. And then 13, which is our final answer. Okay. Now let's check with the horizontal also. 208. Then divide by this 2. I already told you in any manner you can do it. You can take any factor numbers, prime numbers. Okay. So then same you can write. You can just write this number same as it is what you got the answer. Otherwise you can take the different numbers. Okay, 2 5 the 10, 2 to the 4. Then your 26. Then as this number you have to follow as it. Okay. This is our final answer. Then here you have to write 208 is equal to 2 multiply how many times? 4 and then 13. This is our final answer of the horizontal method. I hope you understood by both these methods how we have to solve in horizontal and vertical. Okay. Now try this other example at home and with the practice of this exercise for better understanding.